This is Shop Talk. I'm Lexi Schultz, sitting in for Ria Tanhuat-Cotrillo. The health and wellness sector has grown tremendously in the last few years, and more, people are opting for a healthier lifestyle. Now, it's no surprise that a lot of entrepreneurs, including medical practitioners, have ventured into this industry. Today, we'll talk about what it takes to be in this kind of business and how to succeed in this enterprise. First up, we have Dr. Mary Jane Torres. She's the owner and head doctor of the Zen Institute, a medical spa that has three branches, one of which is at the Sofitel Philippine Plaza. Hi, Dr. MJ. I like your nickname, Dr. MJ.
Hi.
How are you today?
It's good to be here, and it's a pleasure, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's talk about the Zen Institute. You are technically an aesthetic doctor. What's your, you're an aesthetic doctor,
mm-hmm.
okay, because you went into aesthetic medicine. You could have gone into private practice.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you decide to put up something like the Zen Institute?
Okay, you see, the practice of aesthetic medicine, we do not only focus on the outer or physical activity, but basically because of the concept that I thought of, which is creating or integrating aesthetic medicine into a medical spa, it cannot be practiced inside a hospital. And I think doing it all alone in a private clinic, I won't be able to achieve the result of promoting or servicing the so-called medical spa.
Well, medical spa, spa always comes across as very lifestyle-y,
mm-hmm.
you know, as opposed to it being quite doctor-related.
Yes.
What made you decide to go that route?
Okay, let me give you my history and background, you know. Way back, maybe like 9 to 10 years ago, I was a doctor of a fitness center.
Okay.
At the same time, I'm an aesthetic doctor. And through the years, I thought of, you know, being in the fitness center as a doctor, I can integrate and adopt that fitness protocol, integrating it into the practice of aesthetic medicine. Especially when we're doing body sculpting, you know, you cannot sculpt the body without the fitness. Now, that really triggered me and even helped me conceptualize in setting up the so-called medical spa. In fact, it's a new concept, which you can't find it anywhere. It's a concept which meets the East and the West, you know. The East means
traditional medicine.
The traditional medicine.
Right. But that's the West.
Mm-hmm.
And then the East are the other practices.
Of course, yeah, the integrative and alternative medicine and even the lifestyle. So that really brought me into setting up the Zen Institute by creating the concept of the so-called medical spa.
Okay, well, when I think of a spa, I think of massages,
yes.
facials, and mm-hmm. all of this. What exactly do you supply to your customers?
Okay,
in the Zen Institute, what are your packages,
services? Okay,
right.
By the name itself, medical spa. You're correct. We have the facial spa, the body scrub, and other pampering treatments. Because in a medical spa, there is the spa component. And those what you thought about are really the spa component in the medical spa. Now we have to integrate the medical services. Okay, the medical services that we have, of course, is the body sculpting. Okay, we use everything's non-invasive. By the way, that's why it's a medical spa. It's not a surgical spa.
Right, right. Why did you go that route? Non-invasive.
Non-invasive.
Because you could, as an aesthetic doctor, you could have gone the other route.
In fact, I used to do liposurgery.
Okay.
I used to be a liposurgeon.
So what made you change your path?
Okay, number one, because I really wanted to, medically speaking, I wanted to capture, approach the person and the patient as a whole. So the approach will be very much holistic, no? Unlike when you just do surgery, it's a quick fix. Okay, now on the entrepreneur's side, you see, you can cater to a bigger market scale when you go into non-invasive, because not everybody would want to undergo the knife.
Correct.
Yes. So with this non-invasive, non-surgical, then we now cater to even just and a wider age bracket from 18 to 80 years old. And
for non-invasive, 18? People
yes.
go in as early as 18?
Oh, definitely, because
really?
We just have the machines.
Right.
And even younger than 18, because they start getting acne and pimples, their hormones started, they're having these hormonal changes, and we need to treat them as early as their teens.
But some, what are some of these non-invasive treatments?
Okay, for body sculpting, okay. We have the, of course, we combine the mesotherapy, the ultrasound cavitation, we have the so-called lipocryo. These are all machines.
Sounds highfalutin, Doc.
Yes, yes. These are all machines which actually, in a layman's term, we just dissolve the fat.
That's what it is.
Yes, okay. And we do a spot reduction. No, you cannot sculpt the body without weight management. And so we give them a weight management program. So side by side with weight management and body sculpting becomes a holistic approach and becomes a treatment of a medical spa.
And let's talk about, well, your Zen Institute at the Sofitel Philippine Plaza.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you decide to, I guess strategically, why was that location a plus for you?
Okay, number one, you know, Sofitel is really a luxurious hotel. And I think we have the same market. Clientele base. You see sometimes non-invasive procedures become more costly than the invasive one because it's a one-time thing, the invasive procedure. But other than that, you know, Sofitel can be a beginning to our, a strategy for our medical tourism. Okay, what is this medical tourism? Let's say you're a balikbayan, you need to check into a hotel, and you still need to do this treatment. You don't need to go out of the hotel. Just right at the doorstep of the hotel.
One-stop shop.
It's a one-stop shop, the medical spa.
And in terms of medical spa, you say it's a very unique idea.
Mm-hmm.
Would you say there's a lot of competition out there? Not in terms of specifically having other medical spas, but in terms of other spas, or perhaps people who do go for liposuction?
Definitely, like the end result, maybe there's a lot of competition because, but now again, we just have to push for what is safe, what is what can be a lifestyle shift, and which is this one, what can offer something of a holistic approach, a healthy lifestyle, definitely, because before you go into body sculpting, we take your weight, we take your body mass index, etc. Now also, for we have this non-surgical facelifting. Okay, it's
for older, I hope. I hope no 25-year-olds go in there and use it, because sometimes people start young.
Yes, yes, that's true. We call that preventive aging.
Okay.
Have you heard of such?
Yes, but let's not get into that.
Okay,
okay, so what else?
We have this facelift, right. Non-surgical as well. We have this...
All the machines then.
The machines, and this, mm-hmm. We have this latest technique. One is the stem cell technique, or the PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, wherein we use your own platelet. We extract it from your own blood, and we re-inject it into the wrinkle. And I know it's something very very high, and it targets the cellular level. Now we have this one thing also, the instant lift, which is called the thread lift or the power cell lift. We use a it's non-surgical, it's just an injection. But again, you know, these injections can, the pain on this injection can be very much minimized.
Right.
Okay, so you know, it's, you go,
sounds overwhelming.
Yes.
But I'm sure that if they go visit you, you can explain everything to them perfectly fine.
Oh, definitely.
And mm-hmm. In terms of credibility, one of the Singapore-based magazines actually gave you some accolades. Maybe you can talk about that.
Okay, yes. Well, we were one of the top 10 medi spa in Asia,
right.
Maybe because also of our approach and philosophy. Because you see, it's the so-called beauty inside and out. It's very difficult to achieve if you give a quick fix. So again, the repetitive treatments that you go through becomes a lifestyle. And that's where you achieve the inner beauty, the so-called inner beauty.
Because it's not just the outside. Obviously, it's more of a reflection of what you have inside.
Definitely. And that's very Zen.
And how do you keep, I suppose, the level of the accuracy of everything that you do? Because obviously, you've gotten accolades
mm-hmm.
as well. And people know you.
Mm-hmm.
And you're always pushing forward.
Okay.
So what else are you doing to, I guess, make the brand proof?
Okay, so down to our operations, we have constant training among our therapists, among our doctors. We're a team of doctors. And of course, for my part, I never stop studying of what's new, what's the latest, and what's very safe for my patients.
Okay, well, in the Zen Institute in Sofitel, because it's an integral part, they have this whole wellness campaign there as well. So I guess it really suits exactly what you're out to do.
Oh, definitely, because Sofitel being a resort hotel, it really creates the ambience for somebody to look into themselves. You know, go back to the inner self and examine yourself. You want some, not just the peace, but the beauty in it. And Zen offers that beauty inside. Sofitel creates that ambience for us, and it's perfect.
Okay, so maybe you can invite everyone to not only hear about it, but maybe experience it themselves.
Oh, okay, so I'd like to invite everybody at the Zen Institute in Sofitel Philippine Plaza. It's really a wonderful location out there, and all the non-invasive facial contouring and body sculpting is there, plus, of course, the anti-aging and detoxification. So come and try it. I promise you there's no pain.
Thank you so much, Dr. MJ Torres.
You're
all
welcome.
The best to you and the Zen Institute.
Mm-hmm. Thank you too.
Shop Talk will be right back after this short break. Stay with us. Yeah, and then you just have to make one of that.